r/AskReddit. What's a 100% true story from your life that's so ridiculous it seems fake? Got a call on my office phone on my first day of work. Lady wants to set up a time to meet and gives me complex directions. I assumed it was work training. I follow the directions and end up way outside of town in a rural nowhere. Turns out they were trying to sell a trailer and called the wrong number. My friends and I camped out at our church overnight and were using the computer in our preacher's office, and a tab was open to his Amazon order history, which showed that he had recently ordered 2 big black dildos. I should note that he preaches homophobia, and my friends and I believe there's a good chance they were for his own pleasure. I still cringe 4 years later when one of them brings it up. I mean, Hawaii may not seem metal, but I was on my surfboard doing my surfer girl thing with my toe hanging off. I was wearing teal nail polish and I feel a shit ton of pain. A sea turtle mistook my fucking toe for food and bit it so hard it has to be amputated. It broke the knuckle of my second toe. But it took skin too, so that was fun. Hawaii's ducking metal dudes. I was playing catch with a couple of friends at elementary school, and while running, I tripped and split my chin on a giant rock. Blood started gushing out and I could see blood vessels hanging out of my chin. For some reason, 8-year-old me thought the appropriate response was to grab the blood vessels and go, "Oh, SpaghettiOs." Before I passed out from blood loss, I ended up getting 19 stitches, haha. I saved a girl from burning to death in an auto accident. She hates me and says I ruined her life because I wouldn't lie and say Toyota was at fault for her single vehicle accident. Back when I used drugs, I made plans to meet my dealer at our usual gas station. Sometimes he used different cars and or had friends with him. So I see a car back in next to me. Assuming it's him, I got in the passenger's seat to purchase my goods. I gave the money and finally really look at this guy. It's not him. But it gets better. This guy was a dealer too and pulled out a bag of anything I could have wanted. We ended up exchanging numbers and I met him a few more times. My mom's first husband, with whom she had 2 kids with, aka my half-brother and half-sister, tried to murder her. At this time she was living with my dad, my brother, my 2 half-siblings, and me. He hired a hitman. They were communicating over a landline that a garbage man accidentally intercepted the day of the planned murder. This was in the 90s. The garbage man immediately called the police and my entire family was put under protective services with the Navy. Both of my parents were in the Navy at the time. Before the trial, the Maury Show asked my mom to be featured. She declined. Her ex-husband was found guilty. But the hitman was not. My mom and entire family were so terrified of this result and we left the state the next day and never went back. My dad went back a few weeks later to move our stuff out. Back in 2011, I turned 9 years old and I got this notepad as one of my gifts. Call me weird, but I love them and still do today. Anyway, I didn't know what to write on the first page, so I drew on it. It was my very own grave. And on the next few pages I drew my parents and siblings' grave. Even going as far as to draw a happy soul floating away from the damn thing. And I thought it was the best piece of art I ever drew as a 9-year-old. I wanted to draw my classmates' graves too and give it to them. But I thought that would take a lot of paper and time. But imagine their reactions if I handed them a drawing of their own deathbed. Had sex. I found out an ex cheated on me, so I ditched him at a party for another woman. Nothing too extreme, but I forget it happens sometimes. I broke my senior prom. Dancing to a slow song with my date, we ended up kissing halfway through. Which made all our friends cheer. That made everyone stop and look. Which made the DJ stop playing music. Which made everyone start leaving for the after parties. It was a real and then they clapped story, but it actually happened. My parents met. As patients. In a mental hospital. I had a brief conversation with Paul Walker. He was so sweet and his smile was adorable. When we were like 12, me and my cousin found Paulie Shaw's phone number and we called him and he did the wheel to confirm. I've casually run into Ron Jeremy way too many times in my life. I'm not in the industry and have zero reason to be around him. I got a prank call at work asking if we carried condom repair kits. My parents took me to a lot of pick-your-own farms as a baby toddler because it was relaxing and we got to eat fresh, ripe fruit in the field. Sorry, pie workers. One summer day, we're in a fruit orchard and toddler me has wandered to the opposite end of the aisle from where my parents were sitting. My mom calls me back, and upon hearing her, I start running toward her at top toddler speed. The running makes me breathe with my mouth open, and I am about halfway to my parents when a smallish, oddly textured lump flies into my mouth. I instinctively close my mouth, and then I swallow. It occurred to me that I must have swallowed some poor flying insect. I ran with my mouth closed the rest of the way to my parents. A goat ate my ice cream once. My brothers are 14 and 13 years older than me. When I was 3, both of them left for college and my parents and I moved to a small city in elementary school. None of my friends and classmates believed me when I told them I had brothers because they never saw them. I did not have any pictures at hand, since this was in the early 2000s. So I would draw pictures of me and my brothers to prove they did, in fact, exist and weren't just my imaginary older brothers. Only my two closest friends believed me when they were in the house at the same time my brothers were. The dentist injected, from what I remember, 10 or so shots of anesthesia on my gums because it wouldn't go numb. It finally worked on the 11th. The whole procedure would have cost me $1,000. Yet he gave me it for free. I went to a party at the Viper Room that was celebrating the anniversary of the movie Lost Boys. It was a cast reunion and Tom Mack was premiering a new mix of Cry a Little Sister. It was a side event to the Los Angeles Bondage Ball. And Corey Feldman was there. I ended up hanging out with them for a good part of the night. Ron Jeremy was there too. And when I went over to meet him, I tried to shake his hand. Instead, he pulled down my dress and sucked on my left nipple. Kiefer Sutherland did not make an appearance. Edit. I found an article about it. In middle school, someone asked me for my friend's locker combination. I did know his combination, but I didn't trust that this guy wouldn't do something nefarious with it. So I gave him the wrong locker number and a random combination. Dot. And that combination worked to open some random girl's locker. A cashier asked me for ID when I was buying a beer. I showed her my driving license and she tells me that my date of birth isn't possible. She claims it's 2019. How can you be born in 2000? I tried to explain it to her but she just wouldn't get it. After about 5 minutes of standing there in disbelief, she finally says, "Fine, I'll take your word for it this time, but next time bring something less confusing." I walked out of that store thinking WTF just happened. Went out to the bar one New Year's instead of to a party with some gay friends. Gay friend says, "What? It's not like you're going to get laid." I said I wanted to ring in the new year without being completely surrounded by gay men. Had a one night stand with a friend of a friend of a friend. A year or two later, he was on Wheel of Fortune. I realized Pat Sajak knew more about him than I did. Mention it to one of my gay friends. And he said, "Oh yeah." I ended up taking him home from the bar one night. So in my effort to start the year off with a little less gay, I took home a guy who ended up sleeping with my gay friend. When I was 11, I'm 17 now, I was helping my brother with his paper route. Our mom was driving and we would throw it out the window as she called the addresses. I always had to stick my head out of the window to throw. One time, I stuck my head out the window a little too far and fell out of the window. Broke my collarbone, left arm, and I have a permanent scar on my right elbow. We were only going 15 miles per hour, but I almost broke my skull and bled out. Everyone I've told it to doesn't believe me. I was in Berlin for a couple of days with a group of friends. Near our hotel there was a bar that we would always go to at the end of the night, have a couple drinks and then go back to our rooms. It was run by 3 very funny guys. On the last night, we knew that we did not need to be alive tomorrow and could just sleep on the bus back home. So we just kept drinking, while the staff kept putting the chairs on the tables around us. Eventually the 3 guys running the bar went out for a smoke and I jokingly said, "Yeah, you can go home. We'll leave the key under the doormat." The three looked at each other. They were more than an hour over their scheduled shift. And then one of them threw a key at me and said, "There is a letterbox next to the door. Put it there. Leave the money on the bar." We thought they were joking. But they actually left. We felt kinda bad for it. So we didn't abuse the situation. We had another round of cocktails and another beer each and then hand wrote our bill on two napkins and left the money on the table. Okay. So my dealer that morning had some fantastic weed. He broke it up to show me in my high school parking lot because he was so happy with the quality. It was a bud that was hairy. Orange. And had some crystals in it. I paid the man and we smoked it together. I was high all day. But at 9 a.m. I had a study hall. I'm high as balls still and reading a book. Out of the corner of my eye I see this fly. It circles in front of my once. Twice. Then a third time and right then, bam. Slams into my right forearm. I'm of course slightly puzzled so I get into the what the fuck pose and look at where said fly impacted my arm. Just then the fucker rounds the corner and slams right into my forehead. I stagger back slightly in the seat and process what the fuck just happened. The girl next to me starts laughing silently and I ask her, "Did you just see that fly hit me twice?" She laughingly was like, "Yeah bro, I did." So it was in fact real. TLDR, I got high and attacked by a fly. I have lost the toenail of my big right toe 7 times. And none of the others. I was a clumsy kid. So I drop things on it a lot. And obviously I didn't learn to keep that foot out of the way. I shot 2 bees out of the air with a .22 pistol. I was at the gun range and there were like 5 big bees just flying downrange for some reason. I took like 30-40 shots at them and got 2 of them. This was before saving the bees was mainstream, so sorry about that. My parents disowned me a few days after I came out as bisexual to them. We had a giant, huge, fucking enormous group of friends. Roughly 150 of us ran this fucking town. Cops knew us. We did many things. Basically anything that went on we knew about or was a part of. A mother of some other children once tried to hit me in the head with an iron pipe. I was less than 10 years old. And apparently I had annoyed her. Lucky for me she kneed me in the stomach before swinging the pipe. So I curled up. And didn't notice her swinging for my head. But I just ran away. My brother later told me that she actually swung for my head. People are fucking crazy. I broke my wrist trying to save a frog. I was 7 or 8. And I DKY. But I brought a frog I caught up a tree with me. While halfway up. It jumped out of my hand and landed on the ground. My dog was nearby. And I was terrified that he would kill it. So I climbed down really fast. Tripped on a branch and plummeted to the ground. Frog survived. I broke my wrist and bust my lip. Middle school. Sitting at lunch with some friends when my BFF and I notice an Elvis impersonator standing outside the lunchroom. He came in. Blasted Viva Las Vegas on his boombox. And danced on the table. Turns out our principal loved Elvis and it was his birthday. I know it might pale in comparison to some of these stories. But as a 7th grader. It was wild. TL. Dr. Elvis impersonator dances on tables during lunch at my middle school. Probably that I'm extremely dyslexic. Had a hard time learning how to speak when I was younger but ended up getting fluent in English and can read, understand German and French. My mother tongue is Dutch. I used to be so bad at speaking that after elementary school they wanted to send me to a special needs school just because they thought I wasn't 100%. I'm Brazilian and when I was 10 my father brought me to Brazil to meet my family members there. So 6 weeks traveling through Salvador and we've already met a lot of my relatives and I met the wife of my father's cousin and we are talking and she fucking tells me she is Nemo Jr.'s cousin. First I thought it was a joke but then she shows me pictures at family tables and events where she and Nemo Jr. are on. So yeah, no one believes me that one. TBH, I wouldn't either. I swear it's true but can't blame you when you don't believe me. I saw a man smoke salvia out of a pineapple and then walk into a lecture hall to take a midterm. My best friend is a guy and since I am a girl his significant other didn't like that I was single. She gave my BFF an earful about our relationship. I was never inappropriate or intrusive. She decided she wanted to set me up with someone, of course, to get me out of her hair. She badgered my friend until he approached me about the subject. She worked with someone who had a brother that was single. A nice guy. A young widow, yada yada. Fine. I told my friend give him my number. The potential date called me and he did seem like a nice guy. Told me he was widowed. His wife had had cancer. We talked about career and family. He never asked me out. He called 3 more times and never asked me out. Finally, on the 5th call, I got the nerve up to see if we were ever going out on a date. Me. I don't mean to be forward, but I will be going on a long trip soon and was wondering if we are ever going out. Him. I was waiting. Me. What were you waiting for? Him. The funeral. After I bury my wife. My world went spinning and I don't remember how we ended that conversation. I just remember being gobsmacked. Told my best friend if I ever see his girlfriend she was getting a black eye. I'm a black belt at Taekwondo. When I was 6 months old, I had been in the hospital for longer than I was out of it. The emergency brake on my car broke while it was parked on a hill. Crashed itself into a pole. I have been in a lot of car accidents, so nobody believed me that I didn't crash it. When I was 6, I took a train in Poland to visit my aunt. Was sitting in front of the train and the train driver let me come inside to watch him do his job. 15 minutes later he asks if I want to take control and he will tell me what to do. So I ended up being in control of a train with passengers unaware that a 6-year-old was at the controls. My mom recorded a quick video from her Nokia, but the quality is crap. I'm a girl and my crush is a girl and she said she likes me. I have never broken a bone in my body. I have never broken a phone. I am 19 and I have had 3 different phones over the span of 5 years. Reason for getting a new phone. Needed the upgrade. I gave myself a black eye. In my sleep. By headbutting the corner of the desk next to my bed. I still have a scar next to my eye. People didn't believe it was by me being a dumbass. They thought I was in a very bad situation. But yeah. I'm just fucking stupid. Many years ago I met a celebrity. He apparently developed a crush on me because I didn't care about his fame and money. Nothing happened between us because he turned out to be what I call a romantic creep. Like. A stalker. But in a rom-com way. He gave up after 2 years of trying. I had legit North Korean friends. Not affectors either. One of my mom's boyfriends drove her minivan into our living room and kidnapped her for nearly 48 hours. Saw the actor of Yondu, Michio Ruka, at Comic Con 1 year. While driving a few years back. Saw Zac Efron on the freeway. Since his window was down. We asked if we could take a picture. He said sure and threw up a peace sign. Posted the picture of it on my Tumblr. Other people posted the pics to their own accounts and claimed they were the ones who saw him. So now nobody believes it was actually me. Here's the photo I took and the video my friend took. I'm the one saying. That's so weird. I got hit by lightning. 3 days later. I'm outside looking at ominous clouds and hear you should probably move from absolutely everywhere and nowhere at the same time. Okay then. I moved about 15 feet and the spot I was standing when I got the message was promptly struck by a bolt that left me dazzled for a few moments. 3rd time in my life that voice has helped or saved me. I don't ask questions. I broke 2 of my toes trying to jump a wall 2 weeks later. I get hit by a car which hits my broken toes and puts them back in place. Shout out to the hit and run woman. I was walking on a cold day. It was icy out. I was crossing the street and slipped on the ice at the same moment I saw a car coming. I knew I'd fall face first in front of it if I fell forward, so I tilted myself backwards as I slipped. I did a backflip as I slipped and landed on my knees, which still have scars from that landing. Okay, I have 2. Both were told to me by my parents. First, when I was I think 11 months old, I cut 6 teeth in less than 10 minutes. No crying. Whining. Or other pain indicators. 1 minute my mouth was empty. Then 6 of them. Second. When I was 2 I fought a secondly in a cheap fishnet. Unlike most people who try to be faster than the bug. I took a few minutes to walk 5-10 feet away and slowly lower the net all the way to the ground. No last second flick. But slow speed all the way. I was Time Magazine Person of the Year 2006. I've had 4 surgeries in my life. And they have all been on my dick. Big guy works fine now. Brought me out of read only for this one. I was driving down a road that had a pretty thick forest on both sides. I round a bend and see something white on the road. Just a few feet ahead of me. My mind registers that it's a rabbit and I try to brake because I don't want Bugs Bunny all over my windshield. So I'm skidding to a halt and the rabbit is moving along. Seemingly less freaked out than I am. Still probably in range of me hitting him. And then a freaking fox jumps out of the forest to my right. Snatches the little guy in his jaws. Guess what happens when a fox jumps out in front of your car? Yeah. You get fox all over your bumper. Now. This is all already making me freak the fuck out. Both because I've hit something and because how unlikely is that? But then. As I'm getting out of the car. The freaking rabbit just gets up. All covered in blood and runs away. None of my friends believe me. They all say I just hit a fox because I wasn't paying attention and made up this story to cover it up. I'm not the best driver in the world and, admittedly, I did hit that fox. But that rabbit is the only witness and he has a hell of a story to tell. Fargo. A malfunctioning computer back in the dial-up days called the police on me by skipping numbers in a sequence that included 9, 1, 1 in that order. The first person who was being a racist, both the person and I are Asians. But that person's country of ethnic background is richer than mine. Towards me was the mother of my then crush. My brother took some bread and some cheese and decided it would be a good idea to make a gel cheese in the toaster. It was facing up, not sideways. Cheese got everywhere and it was pretty much ruined. BTW, there was like 20. I got food poisoning and Egyptian shits on the same day. I ended up throwing up in one cubicle. Shitting in the other and doing both in the last one. The poor guy had just cleaned them as it was early morning due to us going on a boat trip. Yes. I was forced on a boat trip after this disaster and it gets worse. I threw up in the van on the way into a carrier bag. Pure orange juice. Then got on the boat and sat literally in the toilet with a hose cleaner squirting on me to cool me down. I was just swaying away in the toilet with not a care in the world with the door wide open as another boat passed. I finally took a walk around the boat and got some water. Ended up throwing that all back up over the deck. My dad took me to the front of the boat to sit right at the front where it overhangs. Then this massive wave comes and we went so high and straight down into the water up to my chest. I then passed out for the rest of the boat trip of the downstairs sofa. The time I got accidentally kicked in the face. No one ever believes it was an accident. Remember the children. That take the hand of football, soccer for Americans, players before a match begins. I played in a football team as a child and my whole team held the hand of a certain football player. No one wants to believe me though and there is no video evidence or live stream that can confirm my story. I was stopped by the German police and they asked me what I was doing there. It was past 1 a.m. and I drove a car with the German equivalent of out-of-state plates. An old 1999 Audi A4 Beta. I told him I worked in the town we were in. As an auctioneer. And that's why I was there. He asked why I was working past midnight. I said, well, I'm actually driving past midnight because I bought a used Jaguar and it had yellow temp plates that ran out the day before. So I had to drive it to a mechanic before midnight or I'd need new plates. I had spent the last week repairing it myself and now wanted to get it past inspection. He said, get out of the car. I'm searching you for drugs now. D. I emptied my pockets and had the Jaguar key and a business card with me so I could back up my story. But I don't think he ever truly believed me. I died first. Then was born. I had a complicated birth. Which ultimately ended in me having drowned in blood. I was pronounced dead. Given a time of death etc. that was prior to the actual surgery having been completed. My mother was still unconscious. But my dad was around to be told the news. He went in to say his goodbyes to his dead child. When I gave everyone a fright by coughing up blood and screaming. My favorite part of this actually came years later when I was a teacher. Somehow, the topic of unusual births came up. And I told my story. One of my students shouted, "That is the most metal birth ever. Made my day XD. My dad is getting married to a woman 5 years older than me. She has 3 kids. A 15-year-old, a 5-year-old and a 1-year-old. I have a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old. These boys will now be my new brothers. These boys will be uncles to my boys. And my boys will be their nephews. My son will have an uncle 2 months younger than him. I feel like I am living in You've Got Mail." I was about 6 or 7 when, while taking a bath, the water splashing against the wall randomly ended up forming the perfect image of a face, whitewashed concrete. You could see it very easily. I don't even want to think how insignificant the chances of that happening were. Called my grandfather in to see it and he said I must have drawn it myself. It was drawn better than I ever could have, even today. If you want to get nothing in return, you can like and join my Discord. There is a link in the description.